Hey everyone, it's Akbar, developer advocate at Figma, and I'm here to talk about some developer API updates that we released this week. Starting off with my personal favorite, the Annotations and Measurements API. Now, you can create and edit annotations and measurements using the plugin API. These were in beta since earlier this year, and we've officially launched them this week, and best of all, they come with rich text formatting support. But instead of telling you, why don't I show you? Let's take a look at a sample plugin I cooked up. Here we are in our Figma file. I have this design that has a lot of images, and I know that they're all labeled with what the alt text should be, but I want to make sure that that's really clear for any developers that's going to be working on this. So I'm going to go ahead and activate my plugin. I will use the action menu to show it, and I have this annotation sample plugin here. I'm going to click here. I'm going to select my image, click on here, and then click on annotate images in selection. And right here we have our new annotation. You can see that I gave it a label with some rich text. I have this emoji, I have this bolded title called alt text, and then the description of what it is, as well as a property that's coming for the annotation, the image fill. So this makes it really easy for me to go ahead and create a new annotation. But now I want to do a little bit more than that. I want to be able to annotate every single image that I have in this design, not just on this page, but the other two screens that I have here as well. So I'm going to go ahead and run my plugin again, and this time I'm going to annotate all images on the page. So we see this toast that says we created an annotation and we skipped one. And the one that we skipped is the one that already exists. I just wrote in my code that I don't want to overwrite any annotations. So I'll go ahead and take a look at that. So now if I look at this frame, I can see that all the images here have been annotated and they all have the captions that were on the images. But I can also see that these images on this mobile screen have also been captioned, and also these on this reservations desktop page. So all of my images have been annotated, and all I have to do was run one plugin. Now, this was a really simple example of what you can do with the API, but I can easily imagine some advancements that can be done. For instance, you might take advantage of Vision AI to automatically generate that alt text for these images if they weren't already labeled, or you might make calling out accessibility details a little bit easier for your design and engineering teams by creating annotations that add ARIA labels, that have some guidelines or some templates that make it really easy for a designer to help prep that file. And I can see this being really powerful in design linting workflows to reduce the amount of effort that goes into design prep, while also providing more details for our developers at a glance. So that was a quick look at the Annotations API, but here are a couple of other things that we released this week. We released improvements for prototyping interactions in our plugin and REST APIs. This included things like getting access to multiple interactions on a single node, more advanced prototyping interactions, and being able to set triggers on mouse enter and mouse leave. Now, before we rolled out these improvements, it wasn't possible with the REST API to bring over a full prototype and its interactions. And this meant that anybody that was creating API integrations that pulled in that data needed to live without those additional details or manually try to recreate them. So now it should be a lot easier. We're also rolling out rich text formatting support in the plugin API for component descriptions. So just like you saw in annotations, we'll have that support in component descriptions as well. And this resolves a really old pain where updating these fields with a plugin would mean losing formatting that might have originally been there from the UI. And of course, the annotations that I showed you earlier. You can check out more detailed information about these new APIs in our developer docs and find this annotations plugin sample in our plugin samples repo on GitHub with a link in the description. I'm so excited to see what the community is going to cook up with these APIs, and let us know what you'd like to see next from our extensibility platform.